Let's Hunt is a video series with tactics, weapons, locations, and other useful tips, always around one particular animal. Hello and welcome back to another Let's Hunt. Let's get ready for turkeys. We are here on the northern island of Whitehart Island. I've put a tent here near this tower. I've put a lot of turkey decoys. There are 7 setups along with tree stands or towers. And the plan is to go down here and then down the hill and then alongside the western side of the lake. But you never know where the animals take you. But this area is really packed with turkeys. There's also blacktails and coyotes. But it's a great area. We might use the equipment. We might have to shoot them in the open without any help, without any stands or decoys. That takes a bit more care, but I want to bow hunt the turkeys there today. Okay, before we start, let's have a quick look at the inventory, at the equipment we bring. I'll take the shotgun, I'll take the bow, but also I'll take the 223 bolt action rifle in case I want to do a longer shot on a turkey. Of course, always when using a rifle or a shotgun, there will be noise and you will flush all the turkeys. So preferably I'll stick to the bow, but we'll see how it goes. Starting from this tent, you can still run into whitetails. They are still around here, but not much up further north. So the first call here is mostly whitetail or turkeys already. So it's up to you whether you want to go after them. But I will head for my first setup about 200 meters ahead of me here. You can see it on the Hunter mate. There's a tree stand and there's some turkey decoys. There's a spawn point really around that tree stand where there is elk, whitetails and turkeys spawning. So there's always a lot of activity, and here comes the first whitetail. But I will ignore it. So I will walk down to the decoys and also further down the hill and check if there's any tracks from turkeys. You cannot really tell whether there's a high scoring turkeys just based on the tracks. The heaviest turkeys will give you an 8.7 to 10 kilograms estimation. That's quite a long, wide range. That's at level tracking level 20. It's a wide range and it could really be anything. It could be heavy turkey or not so heavy. It could be a score from 30 up to 65. So it doesn't really tell you a lot. So if you have time, just go after the tracks that you see. Ideally, you find tracks from a group of 4 or 5 males. That's ideal, of course. But also if you hear a female calling, it's worth checking out if there's any toms around worth shooting. So here's my setup. I usually do the 3 decoys. That's the maximum attraction you can produce. And if there's a male decoy, it has a bit more attraction than the females, but that doesn't really make any difference. Also, in this case, I have a tree stand up here. Oh, there's a call. Down there near the road. So what I'll do is I'll call them up here. It might take a while. It's a call from a female, so we don't know whether there is any males in that group as well. And the tree stand is actually up here, and just to show you the distance, it's usually at 30 meters. So this tree stand is exactly at 30 meters away. That's a good distance, a safe distance. They will not spot you up there. They don't smell anything anyway. So the only way to detect you is really by your movements, when they see you or when they hear you. But as long as you sit in a tree stand, there's no movements, and this will be a safe distance. It's also good bow distance, 30 meters. You can nicely measure with the bow whether you have the rangefinder bow sight attached or not. So in this case, it's attached, and the tree stand will be at the second dot, which is 30 meters. But even if you take this off, I can take this off for a moment. You have three pins, 20, 40, and 60 meters. So you could just aim between this first and second dot. That will be your 30 meter distance. And calling from here, I might attract the turkey I've heard, or that group if it's a group. But we might also attract other turkeys around here. There's a lot of them here. So what I will do, I will take my time. I will just sit in the tree stand and call. And once they spot the decoys, they will move to them. Still the same female. Moving closer already. Okay, we'll just wait until they move closer. So I've been waiting here for a few minutes and I just kept calling. And the good thing is, even if you call here, the turkeys will move to your tree stand, but once they spot the decoys, they will go there. And so far, I've really only had this female calling. So she might be on her own. And now we get a call from a male, from a tom, straight ahead. I'm not surprised. So we'll keep calling, and this guy, of course, is located perfectly. When he moves over to me, he will run into the decoys and then ignore my calling location. There still are female around here that we've been calling. I've been just sitting here in the tree stand calling. There she is. And she will come over to my tree stand, and once she spots the decoys, she will go there. So you can keep calling from your tree stand. They will move towards you, but once they see the decoys, those override your calling. So that's a good thing about the tree stand, really. As you can see, she now moves to me and will then hopefully spot the decoys. And this works with females and males. Now you can see how she speeds up her walking. Usually they move fairly slow. They walk, they stand. But once they spot the decoys, that's a nice demonstration here. They keep going fairly quickly to the decoys. And my calling location here is no longer the main attraction. She goes over there to the decoys. That's perfectly to show how effective those are. And if we remember, we are 30 meters away here from the decoys, and she spotted them from even further away and walked right over to them. So that's really ideal. You can sit in your tree stand, you can keep calling. You don't have to worry about them coming to your tree stand and sit around your tree. If your decoys are out in the open like this in this place, that's where they end up. And I can see the turkey ahead of me. At least one. That's a female, and there's a tom. There's two toms coming. There's some issue with the spotting information. It's not always accurate, but you can see this one is a fairly large one, and it's got a long beard, and the one in the back as well. So they both seem to score well, and even though I called again, see where the female sits? She keeps walking around the decoys. Now, if you bow shoot the turkeys, you want to hit them well. They really need to drop on the spot. If they run, they will spook everything. So we should get at least one if we're lucky, and the shot is well placed, and we can take two. I'm gonna let it come closer. They will circle those decoys. They're 30 meters away, so once the turkey stand still. Was a perfect shot, and you can see with the python, it's a very silent bow. Everybody's still around. That's good. There's one more female. So we'll go for the second tom as well. Let it move over here to the decoys. And I think I hit it, but it survived. And it dropped, but nevertheless, it spooked everything. Now, if you do this for competitions, you would stick around and wait and look at every single tom, and of course go for the one with the longest beard. So our first setup here already delivered two toms. Let's pick them up. Let's see what they score. But the score doesn't matter much, really. This is more really to show how you can bow hunt them. I could have gone with the shotgun after the fleeing turkeys. And that's a really nice score, 67. That would actually be a good one for a competition. If you lift them up, you need to lift them by the neck or they will start spinning. And we can spend a lot of time here with the trophy shot now. I'll try not to. Yeah, this is not perfect. As you can see, if you lift it here, it'll start spinning like crazy and it can actually fly away. That's true for all the birds. Geese, ducks, pheasants, and turkeys. So grab them by the neck. And like I said, you can spend a lot of time on the trophy shot here. Since it's a 67 score, I want to have it in my gallery. This is okay. I'm gonna take this. Oh, with the arrow right through the neck. That's pretty cool. So This is my trophy shot. And here is the next. Of course, if I had shot with the shotgun after the fleeing turkeys, I would have spooked everything. There might still be more in the area. Remember that. And 57 is another nice core. So that's the first setup. Looking at the map, I will actually just leave the photo upload. Now it's uploaded. Looking at the map, we'll move down here now. There's more setups. I will go after tracks, or I will go after calls. So in this case, we had a female calling. I called back until it arrived. It came all on its own, so that wasn't successful. But there was another flock attracted to my calling. Another flock in the area, including a 67 scoring turkey tom. So the calling was worth it. And by the way, if you spook turkeys from your tree stand, from your tower, or from your location, whatever it is, just keep calling, they will come back. They do not flee. And there's more turkeys down there, which is near one of my setups. So we'll check it out. But just to finish my statement from before, if you spook turkeys, they will not flee beyond rendering distance. So you can keep calling. Just keep calling, they will come back. Even if you spook them, just sit there, wait, call. Eventually they will come back. Even high-scoring toms, they do run, they do fly, but never beyond the rendering distance. And I had toms coming back for the fourth, fifth time until I finally hit them, or until I hit all of them. So I had the first call down there from this female turkey. And ideally, I would like to get a second to get an idea of where they are moving. If it comes closer, or if it goes away from me, or if it goes west or east. A second call will give you an indication about where they're moving. And there is a second call. Pretty much in the same place. Unfortunately, my tree stand is just opposite of the bird here. And there's a steep hill ahead of me. I cannot easily spot them. So what I'm going to do here actually is I'll try and sneak around the turkeys. The one calling could actually be one of those that was that were fleeing before. So it could be now a single female calling. What I missed doing actually, I should have picked up the tracks from those females. The females that were walking around the decoys that I only spotted, I should have picked up at least one track of them. So now when they call, I can know whether it's them or whether it's a new flock. I forgot to do that. So when you get the call, if you get a second blue dot, you know you attracted already. It's one of those you saw. And if it's only one blue dot, you don't know whether this is a new one or one you already spotted. So they seem to move east, which is the right side of the hunter mate. I might be able to make it to the tree stand. Without running into them. I'll try. Now I hear steps. I already spooked a deer before. I didn't even see what it was. So there's a lot of blacktails in this area, sometimes elk. The set I'm heading for is pretty much the same. I've got a few decoys and then 30 meters away the tree stand for safe shots. 30 meters is a good distance. They will not spot you there. And you can still shoot them fairly well with the bow. As you've seen before, one I hit and it dropped dead on the spot. The other I hit and it ran. So you don't want to go beyond 30 meters. The further away you go, the harder it really gets to drop them on the spot. But also below 30 meters, there's a chance of them spotting you or sensing you somehow. Oh, there's a nice black-tailed deer. That might be the one that ran away before. So this female is extremely stationary. It stays there. There's my decoys. It's been there in the same spot all the time. And here's my tree stand. So then, why don't you calm down? So we'll just look around, maybe we'll see some more or some other activity. The placement of these is not super ideal. They're not seen as easy as the ones you've seen before. But actually it looks like this female already spotted them. I'm calling here from the tree stand, again the same scenario, and yet the turkey is walking to the decoys. So this works perfectly. And she really seems to be on her own again, but that's fine. When you shoot the bow, you want to click and hold and then just release for the shot. So don't click and release at the same time or you might mess up the shot. As you can see, this one also dropped right away. So click the mouse and hold it and then just release for the shot. When you're spot on. So I'm not gonna stick around. I haven't seen many tracks of turkeys yet, really. So I'll move further out around the western side of the lake. Yeah, it was a hard shot. Practicing your bow really helps. And if you got a good shooting skill, you can really hold it quite a while in full draw. Some turkey tracks here. Oh, there's an elk cow ahead of us. This is a good field for turkeys. I think I saw just some blacktails down here. And a white-tail deer. So this is a good field for turkeys. Oftentimes they call from here. And you can really hunt them without all the fancy equipment, without the stand and the decoys. If you have them in a field like here, you can call them over to you. You can use this hill to be elevated to spot them all out and to shoot the one you've selected. But today we have elk, not turkeys. Anyway, we'll move on. Sure, we'll find tracks. We might end up spooking them. Anyway, there's plenty of spots to go here. I'll head over to this next setup. So I'm missing out on the one down here where the black tails ran away and where the white tail was. I'll walk over here to the next tree stand. There's an elk. We don't worry about them today. Or we could follow this flock, but this was an hour ago, so we'll not bother with it. There's a lot of turkeys here ahead of us over in those woods. So I'm pretty sure by the time we get there, we should see some more signs. We haven't seen any coyotes yet. There's also a lot of them here. So mostly blacktails and turkeys, some coyotes, and not too many elk. If you're elk hunting, you can come here, but there's a coyote track. You can come here for elk hunting, but you need to go long ways in between herds. There's a tom in the area. Solid circle already. And that's him. Down there. Okay. Here we have the next set of decoys. And again, tree stand 30 meters away. So I'm now calling this Tom, but I would not be surprised if there's more birds coming. He's far away. So this cow is not going to spook any more animals. By the way, I don't think I've loaded my shotgun yet. Just in case. So. And I hear my Tom flapping, at least I think it is. There he is. Scoring 60 to 70. Can we believe this? Like I said, there's some issue with that estimation with the turkeys. But it sure is a heavy one. He is still a bit suspicious. Just looking around if there's any other activity. No. Yeah, he's got a good beard. There's elk cows around. Ooh, that flapping is not from the turk I'm looking at. I hear flapping, but I don't see this guy flapping the wings. That's where it's coming from. So there's this female that was attracted, and she just spotted the decoys and turned around. So we have more turkeys coming to the party. I just don't know how many. What you can do here is you can lean forward, hit X, and then turn. So you can look behind the tree stand. I don't see any others. Okay. So let's try this Tom with the bow. 32 meters. Oops. Just moving. And it did not die on the spot, but it's down anyway. Double long shot on the cow. The python is really well performing. When it came out, it was a bit of a weak bow, really. But now it's really performing well. You don't want to do shots at 50, 60 meters on larger game. That doesn't make much sense, but for anything close, it's really good. So let's have a look at the score of this one. 61. Okay. And the female ran away. Who cares about that one? So I'm gonna head north towards these setups. Listen for calls, look for tracks, see if there's any activity here. And I actually wanna crouch from here because I've been calling quite a bit. I don't know if there's any other turkeys close now, based on all the calling that I've been doing. There's a decoy, a single decoy up, as you can see on the Hunter mate. It's just one there up in the woods where there's turkey sometimes. But there's also the tower over in the open field where I've done the snake bite video. Lots and lots of animals there, including turkeys. Ooh, there's one. Ooh. See, that is the... That's the result of calling a lot. I'm gonna move right back. Hopefully he didn't see or hear me yet. Oh wow, I almost ran into it. So let's do some calling, move back to the tree stand. So we'll do the same, call from the tree stand and just let them approach, and then hopefully they will end up at the decoys. It was really close. Would be nice to see just more than one, a nice flock of turkey males. That's always the highlight of a turkey hunt. There's one there. We must have picked up a track of that before. So there's one there, one over here. Unless I spooked this one after all. So we'll just wait. This looks pretty good. We have some activity. You can look around the tree stand, but not with the glasses. I might have spooked this guy. Let's see where this one's coming from. No, he's still there. Very nice. And if he arrives early, there he is. 60 to 70. If he arrives early, I might be able to take it out and still have the rest coming. It's a bit of a risk now. They weren't too far away either. Well, I say they, it could be just one Tom. He was calling from back on that hill, maybe 100 meters away. I think I want to take the risk and shoot this one right away. He's close anyway. Turkeys didn't used to have organs. They added lungs and heart to make it a bit harder to hit them or to kill them at once. There's a new one calling. So there's at least two males coming from here. But to finish that story, a few years ago, or initially when the turkeys came out, when you hit them with the bow, at least within 40 meters, they would always drop dead on the spot. And then later, they added organs, a heart and a lung. They're a bit oversized. Actually, there are a lot of oversized. But this added a bit to the challenge of hunting turkeys, especially after they added the 223, a really nice rifle where you can take out turkeys from really far. So they added to the challenge. Not every bow shot is an instant kill now. This one was close and was probably well hit as well. But you can still mess up the shot as you've seen already before. The turkey will die, but it will run first. And of course, it'll spook everything around it. So that's a good challenge, I think. I should see it by now. Or one of these guys at least. Okay. We'll just wait. We have time. And remember, all the calling could attract any turkey in the vicinity. Since there's a lot of them here, as you've seen, I've been calling before. I really only waited for that one male. I got another female coming. And now I have more toms coming. New track from back there. So there's a lot of activity here. And we'll just call. Sit up here, nicely hidden, and hopefully we'll see some turkey toms walk over to the decoys. So there's at least three toms in the area now. You don't have to worry about the wind direction. The turkeys do not smell you. But like I said, they have a good eyesight. Hearing is average, as you've seen before. I mean, this is a good size, good scoring turkey here on the ground. I almost crouched into it. It didn't hear me come. I could turn around, get into the tree stand and lure it over. So these guys take their time. Still over there. Are you stuck or what? There he is. Oh, there's at least three coming. And this one also looks good. 60 to 70. This one? Am I getting this right? 60 to 70 for this one. Well, I can tell from the beard it's a good score. The estimation is not very accurate. This one says 60 to 70. And this one says 60 to 70. Is this right? So there's three big toms coming. Oh, there's another. Wow, this is good. You cannot see it yet. Now you can see it. There it is. So I'll do one last call. And then I will let the decoys do their magic. I'm tempted to use the shotgun on all these. I cannot shoot them all silently, I'm sure. Wow. Oh, there's more. So there's five males. This one is a good one as well. In case of doubt, go for the beard. You can see the long beards here. They're all good. So this is the highlight of a turkey hunt. Five males coming in. How long is it going to take until they see the decoys? Okay, take a turn, guys. Over there. Now he sees me. So this didn't work out. Too bad. We had 5 toms and he's stuck to the tree stand. Let's go down. So this is the view from the turkey. They're right over there. Okay. But what I'll do now is I'll demonstrate that they will come back. I will call them back in. So this might take a while. I'll pick this one up and I will call until they all come back. Just to show you, even if you mess up, even if the setup doesn't quite work. You can still get them back. So let's see here. What I'll do in the meantime is I'll move the decoys. So they are back there, and when I call them, they will come back. So this time I'll set up the decoys so that they cannot miss them. Let's see. That's fine. So I guess I just learned this setup is not perfect. The first setup you've seen, there is the decoys really in the open on an almost flat ground there. The turkeys, no matter where they come from, they will see the decoys. In this case, they didn't see them. One turkey actually stuck underneath my tree until he saw me. Never had this before. Just learned something new. So maybe that means you need to be flexible when turkeys are calling. Quickly move your decoys into the right direction. So this is my new setup. Distance doesn't matter that much because I'll use the shotgun this time. And I will call them back. This will take some time. Just receiving a call from a turkey male pretty close. We had 5 toms and at least 2 of them called before. One died, so I don't know which, if this is one of the callers, but this one said new Oh, there's a blacktail. This one said new track. So it could be one of those that were fleeing. You can still see the circles on the hunter mate. Now they disappear. So this is pretty close already. It appears they're coming back. All you need is patience if this happens. Even if I shot with a shotgun. Yeah, this looks familiar. See, they're already coming back. There's another one. Now, if there's only two... If there's only two right now... I could risk the bow. I could risk it. So even if one is running, he's not going to flush everything else again. 35 meters, let's try it. Oh, that was a nice miss. He was just moving. That could be one other of those that were fleeing before. You have to be quick. 30 meters. And not an instant kill. This turkey is dead. This one's running. That's the risk. But we'll get them all. So that was number two. We'll wait again. Next call coming already. So he wasn't spooked by the fleeing turkey. That's good. So we, out of the three remaining turkeys, one was calling from far away, one was just fleeing. That means none of them is close. And I can take this one out, even if I shoot it badly with the bow. It's not going to spook the rest. This is a bit close to the tree here. Is he detecting the decoys? It looks like it. Very good, very good. So... I had reloaded the arrows, by the way. That's why I was back to 10. This one's perfect. Here comes number four. So this used to be really easy when you had a flock of five turkeys, especially with the crossbow. You could just take them out one by one. They would never spook. But now, if you don't hit a vital organ, the turkey will run a few meters, maybe 5 to 10 meters, and then drop dead and flush everything with that. So this has been made a lot harder, which really is more realistic, I think. By the way, we could have more activity around us again with all the calling. So you can see I spooked them. I even shot the shotgun at one of them. And yet they all come back. They can never flee far enough to escape the range of your caller. So we'll wait for the last to return for a second time, the one that spooked before. We'll take that one out, we'll collect them, and then we'll call it a day. And again, some time has passed, and if I see that right, there he is again. So I've been calling, and he is there for a third time. So we had to rearrange the decoys. So my idea that they would always walk to the decoys didn't work here. I guess they were too far away with the 30 meters. After all, we'll learn as we go. We have our last turkey here. I'm not gonna make a big deal with this one. He's bleeding, and there he's down. Okay, let's pick him up. Maybe one of them will score above 60. But like said, the estimation of the scores is off. So all the 60 to 70s actually can score lower currently, which seems to be the fact. Here's the last one. And also that scored below 60, but we had a 67. We did see some toms. Like said, the five toms coming in, that is the highlight of every hunt. Not easy anymore to get them all. If you lose them, keep calling, they will come back. So we could have gone further. We could have checked out the other places here. They're all good places. There's a lot of turkey activity around here. Check it out. Go and try your bow, your shotgun, or your 223 on the turkeys. Good luck with that. And thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Never got annoyed. Thank you very much. Stay in touch.